Throughout recent years, computer programs that can stimulate conversation with human users, especially over the internet, have been designed and advanced, and such computer programs are generally known as chatbots. In late 2015, Sam Altman and Elon Musk led a small group of people in founding an organization known as OpenAI, an artificial intelligence research laboratory that conducts research in the field of AI with a stated goal of promoting and developing friendly AI in a way that benefits humanity as a whole. With an investment budget of over $1 billion and excellent workers, the company started bringing its amazing products to the market immediately. In August 2021, an artificial intelligence model with the ability to divide single sentences into grammatical parts and then identify those parts in relation to each other was made available. This AI model is known as OpenAI Codex, and it is used in programming auto-completion tools such as Visual Studio Code. OpenAI continued bringing more products such as OpenAI 5, which is a video game program, DALL-E and DALL-E 2, which are both deep learning models that can generate digital images from natural language descriptions. There is also GPT-2, a generative pre-trained transformer tool, and unlike GPT-3, this open-source AI can translate texts, it can summarize passages and even generate text output on a level that is almost indistinguishable from that of a human. In November 2022, OpenAI launched a chatbot named ChatGPT, and that continues to amaze millions. Built on top of the company's GPT 3.5, a family of large language models, fine-tuned with both reinforcement and supervised learning techniques, this chatbot is enabled to do wonders. Trained by AI machine learning, the system is designed to provide information and answer questions through a conversation interface as trained on a large sample of text that it can access on the internet while using the information it gathers in real time. This chatbot can engage a human-like dialogue format conversation, answer follow-up questions, challenge correct premises, admit to its own mistakes, and reject inappropriate requests. ChatGPT is simply a prototype dialogue-based AI that is capable of understanding human language, and from all that, it can generate impressive, detailed, human-like written text. OpenAI, which is the chatbot maker, stated that ChatGPT was created with a focus on ease of use. This means that it doesn't require special skills or knowledge to use ChatGPT, but it delivers now what is considered a threat to the international employment industry. The question now is, should anyone be concerned about this technology? And if the answer is yes, let's find out when Asinga Unfolds. Now, before you continue, I know it's been a few minutes, but thank you for sticking around. Allow me to remind you that for stories in business, technology, science, or current affairs, this is the channel that you should subscribe to. My name is Asinga, and let's get into it. Now, if you or someone you know has been able to use ChatGPT, the most liked story from that user experience would sound similar to that of a Google user, because this chatbot and Google both resemble in many fields. For example, as Google, ChatGPT can provide descriptions, it can give answers or solutions even to your complex questions. Think of something difficult, like writing codes. It can solve layout problems and optimize queries. To any Google user, this technology can sound like an alternative, although real-world applications could include generating content for websites or a YouTube channel, answering customer inquiries, for example, through call and text prompts, providing recommendations, as well as creating automated responses. People somehow started relying on ChatGPT more when it comes to some tasks, such as writing application letters, essays, scripts, and much more, despite this technology being in its early state. Now, we all know that every time people hear about new capable technologies, fears from being replaced in social and economic sectors come up. So, could ChatGPT replace humans? There has been speculation that professions dependent upon content production like here could be rendered obsolete, including everything from playwrights in profession to programmers and journalists. But not just these sectors alone. In just days after its release, academics have generated responses to exam queries that they say would result in full marks if submitted by an undergraduate. And programmers have used the technology to solve coding challenges using obscure programming languages in just a matter of seconds. Due to its potential of answering questions, the New York City Education Board restricted ChatGPT from schools because there are concerns of students using the technology to generate poems, essays, or even use the program to provide homework shortcuts. Now, that sounds to pose a challenge, but should you be worried? I think one should not be concerned about ChatGPT taking over you. At least not yet. According to some users, ChatGPT lacks the ability to truly understand the complexity of human language and conversation. Personally, I feel the same way. Remember, the technology can only generate words based on a given input, but without its ability to comprehend the meaning that is behind these words. This is why users say that the program generates responses which are at times shallow and lack in depth and insight. And that being said, I'm not trashing the entire idea of ChatGPT being able to take over in some fields. You can obviously do things. For example, it helped when I was making the script for this video. And for more than a minute now, I've been saying things from a ChatGPT session and you did not notice. However, in its current stage, the system is more like a demo of what is possible. And it doesn't know anything, or it cannot provide knowledge that is not from existing written material. ChatGPT can also give entirely wrong answers and present misinformation as fact, as in writing plausible sounding but incorrect and nonsensical answers. And for such reasons, I cannot entirely depend on ChatGPT to write me a script for a video on YouTube. According to OpenAI, fixing this issue is almost impossible, because there is no source of truth in the data that they use to train the model. The technology is also taught through supervised training, which is known to mislead, because the ideal answer depends on what the model knows rather than what the human demonstrator knows. I would therefore say that ChatGPT is nothing to pull anyone into worry. Just look at it as you would Google. Despite that, it is worth considering its potential advantages and disadvantages. You cannot tell me that a $2 billion venture doesn't have at least a couple of uses. As much as I agree about ChatGPT being effective in many fields already, I cannot say that the technology is going to replace people's jobs. While it is a powerful tool for automating conversations, it is still a long way from being able to replace the creative and interpersonal skill set of a human. Generative pre-trained technologies are best used in supplement tasks, but not replacing them. I'm looking forward to your opinion, and if you have any, drop it in the comment section below. Speaking about replacing things, watch this next video to see how a very small anti-government group attempted to replace the German constitutional government. Thank you for your time. I'll see you soon.